Jamaican tilapia fish farmers get a raw deal from the manufacturers of tilapia fish food. Stay tuned. Okay, so this is not really a rant, but this is just a practical situation in which I feel that it's more prudent for me to share, meaning that I have been looking at tilapia fish farming for the past, call it 2 months, or near 2 months. Right, today I share insight into, you know, how the tilapia fish farming business in Jamaica is being affected by you know, the feed quality that exists in Jamaica. Well, Jamaica is a small country. It has you could say it measures about roughly about 250 kilometers, right, in length, right, and about less than half of that in width. Jamaica have roughly about 1500 large tilapia fish farmers, and you know, you have super large fish farms, you know, farms that have like 80-90 ponds. I'm talking about one acre, 2 acre pond. You have a few tilapia fish farmers that has like 50-40-30 ponds. Some have 70, some have 80, right? So even along the fish farming you know, group, I would say family in Jamaica, you have different tiers. Now each tier, each group, each set of tilapia fish farmers, they have their mechanism of actually getting feed for their tilapia fish stock. All right, the more affluent, influential, financially, you know, independent tilapia fish farmers are able to import better quality tilapia fish feed from overseas. Currently, there are two manufacturers of feed in Jamaica, right? One is Nutri-Mix and one is, Nutri-Mix? Yeah, you see the words on the screen. And one is Hi Pro, right? One is located in right at the border between Clarendon and St. Catherine. I think it's in St. Catherine, but it's just right on the border, right? A few yards away from the border of Clarendon. And one is located along the shoreline of Kingston, right in front of Kingston Harbor, right? Both industry, both feed producing industry currently produces substandard tilapia fish feed for, you know, local tilapia fish farmers. And when I say substandard, I'm not taking any word from anybody, but I have actually, over the past couple of weeks, I have been testing and I've been doing a lot of work with regards to tilapia feed, tilapia care, you know, weight and all of that. And what I found is that feed that has been sold on the market to, you know, small farmer, fish farmers like myself, the quality is just not there. I mean, like, you throw the feed into the water and if the fish don't get it same time as you throw it in, it sinks. And when it sinks, it actually rots away, depreciating the quality of the water. The feed is not allowed to float on the water, and because it's not allowed to float on the water, the fish not going to dive and take up the feed from off the substrate of the pond. And if you know tilapia, you know, cichlid species, they are surface swimmers. They love the surface. So although you might have some ponds that are 4 feet, 5 feet in depth, right? But anything that touches the surface. Tilapia fish farming should be looked at as a business, right? And not as a means of, you know, whenever it's available, it's available. the larger, remember I shared that over 1500 persons in Jamaica actually farm tilapia, you know, as food fish, you know, commercially. You have some small fish farmers that do exist. They would buy like 4 or 5 dozen you know, fries, fingerlings from Rada, care for them, and when they reach food size, they would actually treat them with you know, sellers on the road, right? And you have persons who would practically have their own root stock, you know, don't business with Rada as to how they sell them, because, you know, as I shared with you before, Rada fingerlings are monosex, they are actually sex reverse, so you only have males, right? Okay, so I'm kind of going off on a tangent here. The main emphasis is on feed, right? But what I'm saying is that the tilapia fish farming business in Jamaica is getting a raw deal. The quality feed that chickens actually get to feed, you know, as feed, so that it grow and grow healthy, far outweighs that of the fish feed. I think a little bit more science is needed so as to actually design or create tilapia fish food that allows the tilapia food fish to be healthy, grow quick, you know, and at the same time they actually do not risk run it doesn't run the risk of actually getting the fish sick. Not to say that the fish feed is bad. There's nothing wrong with the fish feed, right? As far as, you know, what it's supposed to be doing. Feeding the fish, fish get big, fish is sold as food. But as far as we're talking about the floating aspect, the density of the fish feed, it's unacceptable. And what this does, it actually decreases the volume of fish that is output, or should I say that is produced and sold to the market, because you can have 10,000 fries, place them into a pond, and at the same time, because of the quality of feed, you only actually get to sell roughly 4,005. Or because, you know, as I said before, if the feed is not caught by the fish as it is thrown in the pond, you find that, you know, that's just it. It's done. Tilapia fish feed is just not the best quality. When you talk about tilapia fish farming in Puerto Rico, United States of America, in sections of Africa, there's a vast difference. The quality of feed and all that is available to the fish farmers is of a higher standard than that exists in Jamaica. Yes, we have tilapia group, what I call it, farmers group, that actually discuss these matters, but I guess the smaller groups are unable to buy a container of fish feed per month, because that would cost roughly millions of dollars, right? And the smaller fish farmers would have to depend on these two companies, as I mentioned before, Nutri-Mix and Hi Pro, for their feed. And their feed is actually stifling the growth of the smaller fish farmers, you know, growth rate. It's stifling them, because they're not able to produce as much, because, you know, with the whole water situation parameters, do not want it to get twisted, or it to be getting twisted, right, that I am against Nutri-Mix and Hi Pro in their whole production of tilapia fish feed. It's good to see that Jamaica have industries that actually can actually try to be, you know, on the ball as far as tilapia fish farming is concerned, you know, and as to what is on the market, right? You know, tilapia fish farming started from 1976, and you know, we have come a long way, right? However, I think that the industry as it is right now need to evolve a little bit more as far as the quality of food fish farm, the feeding used on food fish farm, right? I think more need to be done, and where possible some incentive need to be created by the Ministry of Agriculture in Jamaica so as to foster creativity, a new design, a new formula that can actually enhance the production of or the creation of fish food that is considered up to par, can be compared to others on the worldwide, or should I say on the international scene. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that I did not bore you with regards to tilapia fish farming. It's a lot that could be said, but for now, let's just leave it at that. Bye.